It's that time of the year, people. It's that time of the year. And I saw this call to animations like a subscribe button, and most of them are really basic animation that you can do in Apple Motion. But today, I want to show you how to do it in Final Cut Pro. So if you're a beginner, this is it. Text animation basics in Final Cut Pro. Let's get it. To create the subscribe button, you will need a background. So let's go to generators here in the title and generator sidebar. Scroll down and look for solids. I'm gonna pick custom so that I can change the color to whatever I want later. Let's also add a custom title because you can do a lot of animation with this one. If you look at all the published parameters, you will see, but we'll talk about that later. But because the custom solid is black by default, let's drag this bright solid right here as a connected clip under our custom solid. That's gonna be our temporary background. Okay, now edit the text. Go to the text inspector and write subscribe because we're doing a subscribe button, right? And then now you can crop the custom solid to fit the title from the left, from the right, top, and bottom. So move these sliders until you get what you want. There you go. I'm also going to trim the length of the solid to about 5 seconds because 10 seconds is too long for this kind of animation. And look at that. It actually matches the length of the text too. So that's pretty cool. Now let's put them together in a compound clip. So right click, compound clip. You can name it whatever you want, of course. Okay, because it's gonna be a lower third, I'm gonna move it by clicking on the transform square right here on the viewers tab and just drag it to the bottom left. Okay, right there. Now double click on the compound clip and let's animate this button. Go to the inspector tab and change the color of the solid to red because it's for YouTube, so red's gonna be our color. I'm gonna try to animate this solid now. So let's create some keyframes in the crop section right here. And keyframes are these little diamonds right here, and they're gonna help us gradually change the value of these parameters. And you know, that's basic animation. That's animation. I'm gonna use the right and the left crop. So let's say we end like this and click here to create the keyframes. Then move the playhead to the start and move these sliders. The keyframes will be created automatically, but look at what we have so far. Not too bad. Starts from the middle of the text and open up to here. And the animation looks very dry, but not too bad. Now let's animate the text position. I always like to start where I want the animation to end, like right here, and then create a keyframe. Move the playhead to the beginning and move the title to the left until you can see it. And this is what we got from that. Now let's go back to the main timeline outside of this compound clip. To make it look a little less amateurish, let's play around with the parameters of the custom title. Let's get inside the compound clip again and select the title. And look at these parameters right here. If you move the tracking slider to the right and then add a little blur to get the motion blur effect, it looks like this. Yeah, looks much better, right? You can also play around with the out animation, and I usually like to do the opposite of what I did with the in animation. So let's take a look at that. Nice or noise. Let me know in the comment section if you know that reference, noise. And you can actually even try to add keyframes on the scale parameter of the compound clip, and then maybe just send it out to end the title animation. You know how to do it. Just create a keyframe here and move the playhead to the end and change the Y position until you can't see the subscribe button anymore. And because you got to this point in the video, Merry Christmas to you. I'm actually giving away this simple animation I just created in Motion, in Apple Motion. I published as many parameters as possible so that you can change colors, animation, and so on and so forth. The link is in the description. And as a bonus, you also get in the link all the other giveaways that I've done in the past. So you'll get another, a little bit more complex text animation. You'll get sound effects, you'll get templates, LUTs, and an adjustment layer. And if you need help installing them, check out this video. And by the way, subscribe if you haven't yet. And I will see you in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.